Hello and welcome back to the DJ Sound Show 2016 fresh. We're back in our London studios and we have Rob Anderson in today.
What's happening?
I'm really excited. For too long, you've been lurking in the shadows. You've appeared in so many of our product videos, you know, like the SB, the SR, the RB, all these different videos where we have wanted someone who was dexterous on the decks.
Right.
And we've always called upon your services to just nail it down and take after take after take. You're just like, yep, yeah, I could do this, I could do that, I could do this. And but now we need you to come out the shadows and do a mix for us, because you are a DJ and a producer in your own right.
Yes, yeah, you know, I'm making music. I'm obviously, I've been a DJ since before I was at Pioneer. That's part, mainly why I'm working here, you know. But yeah, I guess all the product videos is, like you said, it's very smoke and mirrors, and it's a silhouette. Most of the time, the ones I'm doing is, yeah, it's just a silhouette and a set of hands, a set of hairy knuckles on the decks. I've been waiting to get in here.
Yeah, I'm really excited because, you know, even at your, is it UR or your night?
The event we run, so myself and Rick Parkinson run an event. We were calling it UR. It was YOU.R, but everyone seems to call it your. So yeah, we've just sort of,
that's,
it's evolved.
Point as
Yeah. It's evolved into your.
And you've had some amazing guests, haven't you?
Yeah, so we started over 2 years ago, 2.5 years ago, and yeah, we've done bi-monthly parties since and had a string of ridiculous acts, really. And in for a small venue, for a 300-cap venue, we've had like Richie Ahmed, Flash Mob, Cozzy D, Alex
Just
Arnout.
Just ticking off all your heroes, yeah?
Everyone we want to play with, yeah. You know? That sounds weird, but you know, everyone we want to DJ at a party and be on the same bill as, we aim to get.
You're playing their records and you want to get them down and your crowd understand what they're all about because you've been training them well, you know?
Yeah, exactly. Well, some of them have been training us. We've had Zabila in twice. Nice. You know, we've had more acts than that, but it's just off the cuff.
I mean, you know, in a lot of people's eyes, dream job. You know, working for Pioneer, traveling around the country, you know, working on all the new products, having a hand in like product planning, development with the European team, but also training and meeting the DJs as well. You've been around a few houses, haven't you?
Yeah, I get around. It's sick. It is literally an amazing job. You know, it's busy.
Yeah.
Like when I tell people what I do, they're like, oh, really? It is busy, there's a lot of work, but it's all great work, so it doesn't really feel, if you're enjoying it, it's not like it's a labour, is it? It's a labour of love, you know. But yeah, we've had many DJs in here to show them new kit, existing kit.
Nice.
You know, get them up to speed on all the products.
Yeah. Excellent. And also 2016 January we launched the NXS2. And you've got a pair at home. You've been having a little practice, haven't you?
Yeah. I've got a set at home and a set that I take around to show people. Yeah, they're amazing. That's what we're using today.
Personally, how have they changed your performance?
So I thought it was more so the mixer, because the 900 NXS2, the mixer, is the massive upgrade, the beast, if you like. Like, that's got the more of the performance functions on there, but the CDJs as well, man. Like, now I find when I step back to using the old ones, I'm missing most of my hot cues, and like the resolution's much better. It's easier to read the font. There's more information on the screen. It's a lot of aesthetics on there, a lot of aesthetic features that really do aid in your performance, but mainly sound quality in both of them.
Right.
So the effects no longer sound like you're adding an effect. It sounds like it's part of the track.
Part of the music.
Yeah, and same, you know, when you're playing digital out, as we're doing today, WAV files mainly, hopefully all WAV files.
Big, fat, juicy WAVs, yeah.
Yeah,
lots
exactly.
Lots of bottom end, lots of resolution and sort of... you know, the sound stereo image in the top.
And the filtering as well now. I mean, it's a thing we've been trying to improve over the years, and it's gradually got better and better. But I would never mix with filters in the past, whereas now it's like, it's mainly how I'm mixing. You know, I'm still using the EQs, but the filters are so sweet now. You can get it sounding crispy, or you can take out a resonance.
Going now. I think you need to walk round the other side and actually just lay it down now.
Let's do it.
You need to get busy.
On it.
It gives me great pleasure to introduce Rob Anderson here on the DJ Sound Show.
is like finding a tennis woman or a man, however you want to do it. We'll be right back.
Rob Anderson in the mix here on the DJ Sound Show, laying it down, relentless grooves, just love it, hypnotic vibes. Rob, do you want to come around the other side? Let's have a little chat. Having a cheeky swig of the old water. It gets a little bit toasty in here, doesn't it?
Yeah, getting into it as well. Working off a sweat, man.
Great mix.
Thank you.
Deep vibes, chugging, warm.
Yeah, not too quick. Keep it like 1, 2, 3, 2, 4. I'm a big fan of the journey, like trying to build it up, but obviously in 50 minutes, it's condensed, isn't it? So you're trying to, just basically pick 10 or 12.
But there was
bangers.
A lot of tech in there, wasn't there?
That's generally what I play, is like quite rolling, techie kind of sounds like that, yeah.
Nice, but there was a lot of the equipment in there, wasn't there? There was a lot of very subtle manipulation of the sound. Is that what you're trying to aim for?
Yeah, I guess it depends what you play. If you play like glitchy music, then you can go like to town on the effects and make it sound abrasive, but because I try to do it flowing, so you don't want to be too abusive to the sound, you know what I mean? So just like tapping in little delays and using the RMX to bring in
lots of delays, lots of subtle filtering, lots of hot cues.
Like I said, the hot cues, having the 8 hot cues on there now being colored, it's so useful, no hitting the wrong ones. Although I did actually hit wrong ones, but
there was also a cheeky thing that is so frustrating when you're playing, that you bring it the kick in, you bring the snare in on the on the one
that was in the first well we won't say, but that did happen. But that's luckily, but with the hot cues you can jump back
it.
Out
did
and it's live, it's real.
Did you use that using the beat jump?
No.
How you can jump back, or did you just re-trigger the hot
cue? I just re-triggered it like 5 or 6 times.
Nice.
hopefully it would go back in. But it worked out, I think.
Yeah, really nice. And your own productions in the mix?
Yeah, through a couple. I wanted to finish on one, but we run out. I must have gone over time. Yeah. But threw one in there. Some unsigned stuff. Some new stuff, old stuff. Some unreleased stuff. Mainly unreleased. That last one, that's an Anik tune off Under No Illusion, which is forthcoming. Nice. I'm not sure even when that's coming out, but that'll be out soon.
Exclusive,
banger.
Excellent. So when are you next playing? Because aren't you taking over second room duties for Dawley at the Ministry?
Yes, so Dawley and Friends, we've done the last one for him as well, or the one before last. So Ministry of Sound, I don't know the date. It's in May. Dawley and Friends in May. Towards the end of the month.
He can't be doing that many nights in May.
Yeah, so one in London. It's a good lineup. Switches on the lineup in our room. So we're doing a UR takeover in 103. Excellent. Myself, Jordan
and
Peak,
that's the
and
bar,
Longplay.
Isn't it? When they're all,
it's great.
They're dancing along the concrete slab where the bar is and stuff. It's got a great sound system.
It goes off, the box is unbelievable, but the bar is still, really cool room. And we got Jordan Peak headlining as well, so that'll be, grooves, proper grooves.
Excellent. Nice one. So what does the rest of the year bring? Sort of more UR parties, more productions?
Yeah, I mean, I'm getting a lot of music done now, at last, balancing it with Pioneer and, all the rest of life. And I've just put a track out on Under No Illusion, which I didn't play, actually. I was going to play that. Preaching Ease is out now on Under No Illusion Records.
I think it's included in, is it the RR or the RB video?
RR. Yeah, it's in there somewhere.
Yeah, so check out the RR video.
Other than that, that's the first track I've released.
Yeah,
I've been holding them back, and I wanted to put it on.
It's not a bad debut, is it?
Under No Illusion, it's a great label. Yeah, exactly. There's some wicked people on there. And then the rest of this year, I've got a new remix coming out on a remix of a Barber track coming out on Twisted Fusion, which is Apollo 84's label. That's coming out later in the year. And also Curvature Records, which is a new label, but some great people affiliated to it. I've got a remix of an Adam Cotier tune coming out on that.
Nice.
And other than that, make music and play music.
Exactly. And then try to get your head round all the new kit that's coming out.
Yeah, we've got that sampler coming. So it's exciting times at Pioneer as well.
Definitely. Well, thank you so much for coming on the show, and thanks for schooling us. It was really great to actually just hear you just go for it. A lot of fun. So thank you.
Great fun. Thank you.
Safe.
Excellent. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget you can check out this show on our Mixcloud page on Pioneer DJ Radio. So that's mixcloud.com/Pioneer DJ Radio. Very special thanks to my guest this afternoon, Rob Anderson. See you next time. Goodbye.